Francisco and was a very good presentation. I don't know, after is a very good presentation, you might find my point. It's not a, there's no mouse, there's no jokes, but the idea is similar to motivate the students to work on engineering and science. And it's mainly for secretary's education students. So my name is Halis Altun from Mevlana University, Turkey. And actually this is a will be a presentation about a project that we did in the last 2 years. And we, I'd like to give some comments and I'd like to introduce the motivation behind this project. And later on, we actually propose a new project based on the experience with some modification. So I'd like to talk about these issues. So first of all, I'd like to describe the problem, and then I'd like to talk about the project itself and the and then data that we collect during the project activities. And in the last part, we are going to actually discuss some comments and conclusions. Okay. So the main idea is again to attract new generation, because I don't know in Spain, but in Turkey there's a big problem, because most of the students they don't like to go to engineering or science, but they like to go to the other disciplines that they think that they can get a, they can make more money, like a law or like a medicine. So there's a lot of interest in among the students, but because we are in an age which actually we're talking about the knowledge-based societies, and this is directly actually related to innovation, to knowledge creation. So we should have some visual, actually, some actions to attract talented young people to have a knowledge-based society. And this is only possible if the society acknowledges the science and scientific process, and if the society have high level of scientific and technological literacy. But this is only, again only possible if there's a society-wide assimilation of science and scientific process, and we should actually create awareness for science processes, and also we should actually break the misperceptions about the scientific studies, which people think that only some, you know, a clan of elite people can work on this discipline. So the false perceptions developed in the society has negative impact on scientific career, especially for the younger generation. And this actually hinder them having a career in science and engineering. And as a result, there's a lack of interest among them. So we should actually somehow take some action against this problem. And this is problem not just related to developing countries. Studies show that this is the tendency in the developed countries as well. Like United States, you can find a lot of studies about this problem. Okay, but the elimination of this conception is very difficult and requires time-consuming process. And approach of many students and teachers are largely devoid of technological literacy. So we should have some programs and some project to elevate the interest in science and technology. And Turkish scientific and technological council actually started a program called Science and Society, which actually support such kind of studies and projects. So in this project as well, we at the same time actually looks for the metaphors of the students on the subject. And the metaphor is a cognitive structure to define the not well known concept by creating analogies with another concept. So, as I told before, in this project is based on these observations, our aim is to bring out good samples of teaching activities, especially in the secondary education. So there's some technology class, so maybe this outcome of this project can be implemented in this classes. And to do this, actually, we investigate the metaphors of the students related to robots, and to group the identified metaphors into conceptual categories based on the common features. So, by doing this, it would be possible to identify the misconceptions and monitor the metaphor discrepancy. So, now I'd like to talk about the best, after this introduction part, I'd like to talk about the project itself. And we actually organized some activities to improve the scientific thinking, problem identification and solving, and system modeling proficiency, with an emphasis on hearing, vision, and decision making. Because these three topics are actually related to robots. Robots can actually hear, can see, and can make some decisions. So we integrate them into our work. So, at the end, the aim of these activities that we organize in the project is to find out what are the students' specials related to robots, what are the students' metaphors related to robots, and is there any variation on the metaphors after the robotic activities. And we have 5 days long sessions and 5 activities. The first by the way, all the activities actually organized in a competition and game-like actions. So first of all, for example, the game, two humans equal one robots. I'm going to explain this one, and then the other activity is color perception and human eye. Activity three is a gender classification from speech sound using artificial ear software. And the last two is using the Lego Mindstorm robot. Okay, in this first activity, actually, what we did is better to see the first four of the pictures. They actually have two skeletons. One of them actually, as you see, they actually blindfolded. They couldn't see anything, so they just actually controlled by the guy, by the students behind. So they have some protocols actually. They put some labels here. So by touching these labels, the person in front can decide what action should he or she do. So by doing this actually, what we want from these activities, we like to understand that the robots actually consist of mainly two parts. One of the mechanical part and the other the part which controls the mechanism. So this is the first activity. So the students actually have a group of two, and then each team has three groups. So they actually they have competition to carry some form rubber from one point to another point, okay? So the other activity is about the vision. First of all, actually, we asked students to work on the vision, how human can see, how you know, the other animals can see, what's the difference between, for example, human vision and dog vision. So how we can see the objects in color. And then we want them to understand the topics behind. And we didn't say anything, we didn't actually directly give any results, but we asked them to go and investigate and make some research in a group. So they have another, this is another competition. So we actually created a software which actually simulate the colors. There's a main colors, RGB colors. So students actually, after studying this topic, they understood the colors can be, any color can be constructed from three main colors. So what they do, they use this software which is produced by our team, and running under Linux, and they actually decide the amount of the paint. If they actually determine the paint, a ball comes from here and there's a squeezer here, which goes down like that, and squeeze the ball. For example, the students trying to get the particle on the cup by checking the color. So this is another activities, again in competition. And this is the third activity. Again, we have a groups of students. They have a competition again. And here actually, idea is to understand the sound, the physics of sound. We produce again two different program. That program actually, they control the amplitude and the frequency of the sound, so they can understand what's the high frequency. The result of the high frequency produce high pitch, so they can understand later on. We ask them how human can distinguish between woman and man and female sound voice. And we produce another software here, which actually detect the male or female voice. If the group can actually have a correct settings. So they try to actually find out what's the correct settings for to classify the human, the male and female voice. And they later on actually they what they do later on they for example there's a girl trying to speak like a boy to just cheat the computer, but they play some like it. So the idea here again to understand the students that the robots can hear based on the physics of sound. So this is the activities, and again for each activities there's a competition, and they win some gifts if they became first or second or third group. And later on we have a Lego Maelstrom assembly. So we put all the material. They actually have a group of students. They actually compete again, and the first one get some prize, some awards. So as you know, the Lego can be actually very flexible. They can actually produce easily the program using some drag and drop facilities. So in the first activity, actually they just assembled the robot, and in the last one, actually we actually asked them to come with an idea of robotic application. So each group actually has a different idea, and there was a referee group, referee of three or four, they decide which idea was good. So this is the end of the second part. Now I'd like to talk about the data collections, but I should go fast. I think you have 4 minutes left. Okay, well, this part is very difficult for me because this part is mainly related to educational science. Our groups, in our group, there are three experts in education faculty. So they actually, what we did during this, all the activities, we actually collect some data. My colleagues from education department actually, have a framework, they actually set the methodology, and it's called a descriptive scan model, the control group, and pretest, post-test, semi-experimental patterns is utilized. I should go faster, maybe. Okay, we use our scale for understanding nature of science, which proposed by Jan in 2008, and we have for the A students from three different types of high schools in Konya City. Scale step has 35 items, which are grouped in three factors. One of these size, and 12 items in this factor. The other is scientific knowledge, and 14 items. There are 40 items to measure the students' perception towards scientific knowledge. Another one is scientists, and there's 9 items in order to measure the students' perceptions towards scientists. So this is a Likert type scale with a low score of 35 and high score is 175. And at the same time, actually, we collect some data about the metaphors. These are actually identified before and after the activities. And metaphors is something like, you know, open-ended questions. For example, we ask a student to, you know, fill these gaps. Robins like what and why? And we use especially use this phrase because food processor in Turkish literally is a kitchen robot. So we, you know, ask this question about the metaphors. And after getting the data, some statistical analysis such as frequency, percentage, amount, widely, crucial prevalence, and t-test have been carried out. And the perception of the students is found to be 79%, which is medium, and 20 high. We found out that there's no difference between gender, no meaningful differences, and at the same time there's no meaningful differences between type of high schools. In Turkey there are 6 or 7 different high schools, some of them is vocational high schools, some of them is more technical, but there's no such a differences in our cases. And project activities actually project activities have some influence in increasing the affecting the students' perceptions. And this is another table. We actually asked students how was the, you know, how interesting they found each activity, and they like 83% like the last activities. These two activities, because they think they are more theoretical, more abstract topics, so they didn't like too much about, so we should focus on to improve these activities. And they like the other activities, as I told you. About the metaphors, out of time, I'm sorry. Okay. Okay, then. So I should pass maybe quicker. There are some metaphors. No, our colleagues actually recognize 4 groups of metaphors. Human with ability to think, robots actually can be considered like that. Some of the students are giving here. And Some the other category is robots are unable to think and act like human. Some of the students answer giving here about this category, and some of the students actually consider the robots as a machine. And for example, one of them says that the robots is like airplane, since they have to save time and help us to do too much in a short time. Okay, this is another category. Some of them says that robots is like a rubbish bin, since it is full of but only with invaluable things. It was strange. Anyway, so this is the results. Pre-test and post-test, as you can see, there's a difference, there's improvements. And about these three metaphors, actually, there's improvements after the activities. So the activities actually has an influence in correcting misperception about the robots. Okay, there's some past conclusion, but no time. Just 2 minutes, okay? Alright, okay, I'll go fast. As I told you, this project actually about integrating the technology education in the secondary level schools to help students develop a positive attitude towards engineering and technology. And okay, so at the end we saw that the students like the type of activities which are more hands-on experiments. They don't like the activities which are more abstract and theoretical. And about the metaphors, we can actually have a conclusion here that these activities actually improve the perception of the. Okay, I think that one is good. In order to create awareness and develop attitudes towards science and technology, such project activities should be supported with concrete experience and high level of interaction. And okay, the main weakness we realized is that we don't have any teacher training here. Okay, so it means that there's no sustainable effect in our project. So we decided to have another project which involve teacher training. What we're going to do, we're going to actually, instead of having the students in the university, we'd like to bring some students from different schools. So we're going to teach them first of all, and then they should go their school and they have their own team. Later on, we're going to have a competition. So this is the idea that we're going to introduce this year. Thank you very much for your patience.